As you'll see, a well-balanced motor makes all the difference. Hi guys, this is Yasmin from Tighter Robotics. Today I'm going to show you how to balance your motor using a flight stand. This video is a follow-up to our other video demonstrating how to balance your propellers. We recommend first balancing your motor, then balancing your motor and propeller together. Open the flight stand software and enter your license key in the setup menu. If you haven't purchased the license, contact our sales team using the link in the description. Make sure your ESC and powertrain are mapped in the powertrain mapping tab, then head over to the balancing tab. Click new balancing session and enter the settings for your session. You can give your test a title and name your operator, motor, and propeller. Then select the flight stand you are using for rotation speed, vibration, and ESC throttle. Next, enter your rotor mass, which includes all the rotating parts of your motor, next to the operating speed, which should be the RPM at which you intend to operate during a real flight. The correction radius is the distance from the center of the motor at which you will place your correction weight. For the number of blades, select disc. Click create and activate the ESC for your initial run. Spin your motor without any additional weight so the software can begin to characterize it. Drag the throttle up until you achieve your target RPM and click capture. The software will then tell you how much weight to add to your motor for your trial run. The trial weight does not need to be exact, and in this case adding over a gram of tape would be quite a lot, so we will weigh out 0.7 grams of tape. Make sure to turn off power to your system before approaching the motor. The trial tape is added as 0 degrees, and at this step you can designate any position on your rotor as 0, but ensure that you mark or remember this position as it will be relevant in later steps. After adding and recording your trial weight, turn on your power and increase your throttle to your target RPM. Then click capture.
As you can see, the quality grade is below 6.3 and is therefore end tolerance. The motor already meets the standards we set, so no correction is required, but the software will still propose a correction to reach an even better balance. For the purposes of this video, we will apply the recommended correction weight, which is approximately 0.047 grams, at 176.2 degrees. When determining where to add your weight, note that the phase increases in the opposite direction as the direction of rotation of the motor. Make sure to remove the trial weight from your motor before adding your correction weight. Then, as before, turn on your power supply, enter the actual weight and position of the correction weight, and drag your throttle up to your operating RPM. Click capture and wait for the result. As you can see, the final quality grade is now even lower, meaning our motor is more balanced than when we began. In the report tab, we can also see a log of the steps we followed, and in the balancing menu, we have a record of all our balancing sessions. Thanks for watching our tutorial on how to balance a motor with your flight stand. If you found this content useful, don't forget to like and subscribe, and check out our other videos on propeller balancing and testing.